Hey guys, welcome back to Andy's Dinosaur Reviews, and today we are going to take a look at another of these amazing 2020 Collect Day figures, and this one is one that many people are extremely excited about, as there does seem to be a pretty strong following for the Supreme Deluxe line from Collect Day, and that is exactly what we get here. This is actually the fourth pterosaur, I believe, to be added to this line. There have been some very, very nice pterosaurs in the past, and personally, I am absolutely head over heels in love with the Supreme Deluxe line from Collect Day, because nobody else is making very large pterosaurs like this that I can think of. Unless you're going to buy a resin kit, you're just not going to find large pterosaur figures like you see with this one, and then they have a Dimorphodon and a few others. Honestly, I love the large size. It almost looks like a real living pterosaur right here in front of me due to the larger size, but also the amazing sculpt and paintwork here done by Collect Day. Personally, this may be my favorite figure for the 2020 line from Collect Day. It's really going to be a tough one to beat out. There are a lot of very strong contenders, but man, this thing is just super nice in person. So, without further ado, let's get a closer look at this Caviramus. So this review here may actually be a little complicated to do as usual when it comes to these large pterosaurs. When you have things like the wings and everything popping out kind of getting in the way, it's going to be tough to get the perfect close-up shots like we want to. But right here we can see a wonderful shot of the head sculpt of this pterosaur. And looking at it straight away, look how beautiful that black eye is. Really, really nicely painted, beautifully glossed as well, and has an extremely realistic and very lifelike appearance to it. But you can also see just how incredible the very fine detailing of like the skin texture and everything else on the face is. It is really, really nicely done. Look at the beautiful skin texture on the lower jaw, and then up here. Really nice, very fine skin texture all over. Beautiful nostrils sculpted out there. When we actually come up into this very cool looking crest on the pterosaur, you can kind of see a few bumps, kind of like some osteoderm sticking out here and there. But again, the wonderful skin texture looks fantastic all over the place. And you can see some really nice color variation throughout the head as well. You've got like a darker red that kind of tapers off to a fairly light reddish type of a color here in the front. And you see the same similar thing down here in the front of the face, close to the eye, and then it tapers off once again to a lighter coloration of the red. The closer we get out to the tip of the snout, you can also see the nostrils have been kind of darkened around the area. Again, just giving it some really nice color variation, and I think it looks great overall. The jaw, as usual, is articulated. Once you open it up, you can see that the skin flap inside the mouth is painted in the same similar coloration to the rest of the dark red that you see there. The actual tongue, which is going to be probably impossible to get a good shot of, you can kind of see it there, is painted with a pinkish coloration, quite realistic as far as the tone of color used. The tongue appears to be sculpted pretty nicely. There, you can see a little bit in there. Some decent sculpt work there on the inside of the mouth, on the upper jaw as well. So that looks really nice. The teeth are painted with a nice white coloration. You can see they are a little bit sloppy, and by sloppy, I just mean the paint hasn't actually gone up the entire way on the teeth. So there is some kind of areas of the teeth that are similar in coloration to the rest of the head. The lower jaw actually looks pretty good. It looks a little bit sloppy right there, but for the most part, it looks better, I think, than these teeth on the upper jaw. If we turn it around without knocking the camera over, we can take a look at these teeth. Yeah, you kind of have the same similar situation where there's sort of like that little area where you can still see some of the teeth haven't been painted perfectly, but honestly, from a little step away, that's not anything that you're really going to pick up on, and I don't think it takes away from the figure at all, because this thing is just so beautiful, it would really be hard to come up with a reason not to like it. As we lead back here into the eye socket area, you can see some really nice detailing all around the eye. You can also see the ears are sculpted out right there. The pycnofibers start to pick up and they look really beautifully sculpted. You can see that primarily we have this white area of the pycnofibers, but then it quickly transitions to a green. And then once we get into the green, you have kind of like some dark green spots all over the place. The pycnofibers look great as we lead back into the neck here. Even the underside, you've got a little bit of hanging skin right here in the throat. And then that tapers off down here into the chest. That also looks really cool. Also, beautiful pycnofibers sculpted on there as well. If we look at the upper part of the back, you can see once again that the pycnofibers look very similar to pretty much all of the pterosaurs from Collect Day as far as the way they're sculpted, but I think that is definitely a good thing because they're always really, really nicely sculpted. We lead out here onto the arms, and you can see that the arms continue with the pycnofibers, the beautiful green and those dark green spots all over the place. You can also kind of get a sense of the bone structure of the arm as we lead out into the wing, and we come out here to the hand. The hand transitions from the green back to that reddish coloration. Again, the pycnofibers taper off here and then turn into just skin, which is very similar to what we see on the face as far as the reddish coloration. You've got some nicely painted nails here with a gray, and then we lead back here, and then as we lead back into the wing, you can see the skin flap here of the wing, aside from sporting some incredible sculpt work and detail, also transitions to that light reddish type of a color, similar to what you see up on the head of the pterosaur. So it really makes the paintwork very consistent. You can kind of see some different tones of color throughout that have been added in as we turn it and kind of rock the pterosaur back and forth and allow the light to pick up on it. It definitely looks extremely realistic, and I love the color choice that they chose here for the actual skin of the wings. I think it looks fantastic and is definitely a really good choice. As far as the detailing again of the wing, sorry, I'm banging into the camera, but as far as the detailing of the wing, again, you can see even some imperfections in the actual skin flap of the wing. You can see a few bumps and stuff here and there, kind of like osteoderm type bumps, and we lead out here to the point of the wing, which looks really, really good as well. If we take a look at the opposing wing, again, it's kind of tough to get this guy in here because it's such a big figure. You can again see that reddish type of a coloration here on the inside of the upper part of the wing and the really nicely sculpted out arm that continues all the way through the wing. You can see that the bone structure is somewhat visible once again. You can definitely get the feeling that there is like a bone structure underneath what you're looking at, which is really cool. Definitely a very realistic appearance. And then we once again transition out to that reddish coloration, nicely painted nails with the gray, and then we run back here into the wing, and once again, look at the insane detail in the actual skin flap of the wing. Really, really beautiful. This pterosaur, every single time Collect Day releases one of these Supreme Deluxe pterosaurs, I am continuously blown away. Even looking at the underside, even the underside of the hand here of the wing, look at how beautiful that detailing is. And then we run back here into the wing, and once again, the detailing of the actual skin flap looks incredible all over the place with the skin within the wing. Definitely looks really good, and you can see how beautifully it stretches. It looks extremely, extremely realistic, basically showing off exactly how the skin of the wing would be moving for the stance that the pterosaur is in. Even back here, look at the beautiful movement being shown with the way that the skin is stretching. Really, really amazing stuff. The entire underside sports this really bright whitish coloration, and again, the wonderful pycnofibers look fantastic everywhere as far as the sculpt work goes. It looks like maybe some of the white of the body has actually gotten in here, but not too much. I don't really think that's a big issue at all. And then if we look over here on the underside of this wing, once again, it looks very similar to what we saw on the other side, but it looks beautiful on both sides. And again, it looks incredible as far as the detailing goes, but also just the different ways that the skin is kind of folding and bending and stretching throughout the wings. Really, really beautifully and very realistically showing the movement of this pterosaur. Then as we lead back here, you can see a cloaca is present. Once again, very nice detailing for the underside of the feet. You can see the nails are painted with a grayish coloration, just like the hands were. If we look up here, you can see how nice the leg sculpt is. Very, very nice pycnofibers that run down. You can also get a sense of kind of some musculature there in the thigh and calf area. And then we get down, you can see the very nicely sculpted foot. It's a little bit hard to see. Again, this pterosaur is somewhat awkward to review. But then we lead out the length of the tail out to that very cool tip of the tail with that very nice skin texture. You can again see some imperfections. Maybe this was slit at one point on the pterosaur, making it look extremely realistic and really beautifully showing a dose of realism within the pterosaur. I think the only downside I can say is right here as this runs out, you can clearly see that pycnofibers have been sculpted out all the way out here onto the tail, but they kind of just gave it like the same coloration as the skin. They should have probably continued with that green right into here. So that is a slight downside, but I really don't think it takes away from it very much because honestly, you probably won't even notice it from a distance. But up close, it is something that is worth noting. And once again, back here in the tail, you can also see quite a few different variations of reds and everything included, once again showing some really nice, very realistic skin tone. And then looking over here at this leg is the only area I think we didn't get to see quite yet. You can once again see some of the green has run down here onto the skin flap here back behind the leg. So there is a little bit of sloppiness with the paint, but personally, I don't think it takes away from the figure at all because it is just so incredibly striking and beautiful that there is absolutely zero chance that I would be anything but in love with this unbelievable Cavi Grimus. As far as a size goes, again, being a Supreme Deluxe figure, it's quite large, and I have to go kind of further away than normal to actually show you the measurement on this. So for a length, you're looking at about a foot in length, almost on the dot, or about 31 centimeters. For a height, to the tip of the tail, about 8 inches or 20 centimeters. To the tip of this wing, about 7 inches or 18 centimeters. And to the tip of the crest, about 5.5 inches or 14 centimeters. For a size comparison, here is the Papo T-Rex, the Attack Pack Colovosaurus, and Robert Muldoon from the Jurassic World line. And you can see just how insanely small they are in comparison to this deluxe, this Supreme Deluxe Cavi Grimus from Collect Day. This figure is very large, definitely a very, very big, very, very striking looking figure. The sheer size of it just makes you immediately take note to how incredible looking this is the second you see it, and that's exactly what happened when I pulled it out of the package. I was blown away, which seems to happen every single year when Collect Day releases one of these Supreme Deluxe Pterosaurs. I am continuously impressed more and more, and I could not be happier to have this in my collection, and showing you how incredibly large it is just another of the many beautiful selling points of this figure. So this Supreme Deluxe Cavi Grimus from Collect Day for their 2020 prehistoric line is just absolutely incredible. Collect Day continues to blow me away with their 2020 line. This is 5 figures now for this line that I have reviewed for the new 2020 line from Collect Day, and 5 figures that I have been head over heels in love with. Every single one has been fantastic so far. So that just shows you how much work has gone into this incredible new line from Collect Day. But this Cavi Grimus itself is just off the charts beautiful. I love the pose that it's in. It's in kind of a crouching pose, maybe looking like it's creeping along on a tree branch or a log or something, looking like it's maybe searching for something to take a bite to eat and trying to be a bit stealthy in the process, or maybe it's crouching to take off and it's about to fly away. Regardless, I think the pose looks really nice, very dynamic, very beautiful. The detailing of the figure is off the charts. You can see so much incredible movement just shown specifically in the skin flaps of the wings. The way all the skin folds and bends and curves and arches all over the wings is just incredible. It honestly is amazing how beautifully sculpted all the movement throughout this pterosaur is. It is truly remarkable when you actually get this in person and see this figure up close. It just blows me away every single time I look at it. This guy's been just chilling in my bedroom now for a few days because I cannot get enough of this pterosaur. I just haven't found a way to bring myself to throw this guy into storage, even though I have no room for it at all. It is just so incredible that I can't help but to keep it out. And I'm also considering taking this pterosaur and putting it on my wife's chest when she's sleeping so she wakes up and will probably have a heart attack, so I guess maybe that wouldn't be good, but it would be fun to see her reaction. Regardless, the paint job of the figure I think is also really quite nicely done. Beautiful tones of color used, allowing the figure to have a very striking appearance with the usage of the red, especially up on the crest, and that beautiful white area all around the eye I think was really nicely done. Very nice choices on the part of Collect Day to give this an extremely natural look, definitely the type of coloration I could see on a real living pterosaur, but at the same time giving it a beautiful, somewhat vibrant appearance with the reds, but it's also sort of like darker tones, so they're very realistic at the same time. So overall, this Cavi Grimus from Collect Day is a surefire win. Completely awesome in person, and I cannot possibly recommend this figure any more than I already do. So definitely, without question, when this figure goes up for sale, anybody interested, make sure you pick it up right away because it is an absolutely amazing looking pterosaur figure, again from Collect Day. So keep checking back to DeJenkins.com and EverythingDinosaur.com. When this goes into stock, make sure you pick it up because trust me, you'll never ever regret that purchase. But before you do that, don't forget to please like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next review. Thanks for watching.